try.
Well, a big Easter weekend of footy, and Stephen Hoiles joins us to review it all. Let's start at the back end of the week in the big Aussie derby between the Reds and the Waratahs. Seth Fa'angase to miss a week after that off-field red card was made a week suspension. What do you make of it?
Yeah, it was an odd scenario, really. Both players put a knee to Hugh Roach's head. Not vicious or nasty, but just almost a little bit of trying to stamp their authority from their dominant scrum. But both players clearly put a knee on the head. One player gets yellow carded. That player doesn't get cited. The other player who didn't get yellow carded gets cited and finds a loophole in the system. The whole TMO discussion between the referee at the moment in Super Rugby is a blight on the game, I feel. It's just, you don't want to hear the inaccuracies between the TMO and the referee. I think there's got to be something that needs to be changed about the process. I know the league's brought in a bunker and whatnot, but rugby needs to tidy that up, because the communication, the time it drags out, it seems as though the ref and the TMO are just having a conversation. Generally, they tend to disagree and they make their own minds up, really.
As a former player, I mean, you're still running about a bit here and there, but now watching, what do you make of that conversation? Is it frustrating for the players out there? Do they know who is in charge? I mean, we saw an incident in the Rebels game with Dom Shipley penalised for an intentional knockback where the TMO might have thought it was otherwise, that he was trying to ground it. Is it confusing for players?
It's just time-wasting, not just for the players, but for the audience. There seems to be such pressure put on these officials to get the decision right, that they're so paranoid that they take so much time, and that's the thing we don't want to see. Rugby's a fast physical game, and we can't have these long extended breaks, and just the conversation, the actual dialogue between the two is really unclear, and it doesn't actually give you any indication of who's in charge. No, so when you walk onto the field, you know the referee's in charge of the decisions, but the fact that the TMO can go back and look at foul play and then they can make comments here and there, but sometimes the referee listens to them, sometimes he makes his own mind up. I do like the way other codes do it, league in particular, where when it does go upstairs, it is that person's decision. At the moment, it's very grey.
Let's go another decision that was made in that game. Bernard Foley, was it a knock-on when he took the quick tap and kicked it deep and then forced the penalty to kick the match-winning penalty? Was it a knock-on in the lead-up?
I didn't think his hand touched it, no. I also thought there was probably... was it the Prince of Ballymore was there?
Lalawiffy
was there. I felt that he was probably potentially in the way, and the right decision was made in the end. So I don't think Bernard touched it, no.
All right, put you on the spot. Your highlight from the weekend and your low light.
The highlight was probably the first minute of the game, first 20 seconds of the game in Bloemfontein,
yes,
where the Brumbies looked like they scored one of the tries of the season. The low light was when it was disallowed from a forward pass out of Scotty Farty's hand. So it was the same moment. Highlight and low light was the same thing.
Well, there's plenty of footy to look forward to this weekend. You can catch all the reviews, previews and reaction on Rugby.com.au.